So today we're going to work with the Jesner's Chemical Peel Solution. And we have Chris. And Chris, I'd like to ask you a little bit about your skin, maybe the skin condition or any concerns that you have.
Well, I don't like the texture.
Okay.
It's hard to put makeup on sometimes. It's rough here and here.
Okay.
Lines. I have some fine lines here and some worse there.
Okay.
And down here it's starting to get bad too.
Okay. Is it like just a little bit rough in the neck area, a little crepey?
Yes.
Okay. And what about the moisture level of your skin? Is it dry? Is it oily? Is it normal?
Mm-hmm. No, it seems pretty normal.
Pretty normal? Okay, great. All right, well, are there any medications that you're taking, or do you have any sensitivities or allergies you need to tell me about?
No.
No? Okay, great. And I'd just like to ask you a little bit about your lifestyle. Are you indoors, outdoors? What's that like?
Well, I work inside, so
okay.
I'm in all day.
Okay.
Weekends, I like to be out, walk,
okay.
Work in the garden, something
all right.
like that.
Are you pretty good about wearing your sunscreen when you're outdoors?
Yes.
Okay. All
Always.
Right. All right. Great. All right. Well, then we'll get started. So here we are. We are getting ready to perform the Jesner's Chemical Peel. So the Jesner's Peel is a great option for Chris. It's also very good to use on the oily or the acneic skin types. It's also used for light complexion or irregular pigmentation on the skin. So with that, we're going to get started. First, I like to wet my hands and use the cleansing wash. I just like to distribute this over the face and neck evenly. The cleansing wash will lift all of the makeup from the skin, any surface oils. It's non-acidic, so it's very gentle, can be used around the eye area. And I like to work this product in and on the skin for about a minute. Okay. Now I just want to remove the product with a warm towel. Chris, just let me know if this towel is too warm. Okay, just gently wipe the product from the skin surface. Once you have this product thoroughly removed from the surface, you will want to grab an absorbent material like a Kleenex or a paper towel because you want to thoroughly dry the skin. Using an absorbent tissue or paper towel really helps to draw all the moisture out of the follicles. Unfortunately, a terry cloth towel just won't do that. So this is the best method for removing all of the moisture from the skin. And that's very necessary for our next step. Our next step is using the new peel, Natural Enzyme Peel. I take one pump of that and spread it evenly over the skin, covering the neck and the face. This is using papaya enzymes to gently lift and separate the dead skin cells from the live tissue. This product doesn't have any beads, has no acids, so it's a non-irritating exfoliation to the skin, and it will begin to just ball up under my fingertips. That takes about 2 minutes. At that point, you can remove the product. This is a very relaxing and soothing way to cleanse the skin and prepare it for the upcoming chemical peel. Once we have completely removed the new peel, Natural Enzyme Peel, we will proceed with applying the fruit acid exfoliant with two of the gentle action applicator pads and two pumps. We'll go evenly over the skin. Now for a regular facial, you just want to go over the skin evenly one time. But for a chemical peel, you want to be a little bit more assertive when applying the fruit acid exfoliant. You want to completely and thoroughly rid the skin of any leftover product or any surface oils. This is a much better preparation for the skin than the old standard acetone. The acetone would sometimes create a very poor environment for the chemical peel to be applied. The pH would be very imbalanced. The fruit acid exfoliant cleanses that skin, rids it of any surface oils without disturbing the pH and throwing off the performance of your chemical peel. Okay. Sometimes the skin can be a little bit stingy at this point. It's a little bit stingy. Okay. I like to just cool the skin down and blow away any fumes from the skin surface before applying the Jesner solution. Always direct the fan down as to not blow fumes up the nose. Now to the Jesner's chemical peel solution. I like to use a 4x4 gauze folded in half and then in a C fold. Before applying the clarifying Jesner's peel, I like to go over with my client what to expect. Many times clients have had alpha hydroxy acid peels, glycolic or lactic, and that sensation that occurs on the skin is more of a stinging or an itching. However, using a Jesner solution is a little different. There may be slight stinging, but the sensation is really more of warmth or heat in the skin. I like to talk to my patients and describe that we're going to stay on track with one another by using a scale of 1 to 10. 1 being the skin's completely comfortable, 10 being the skin is very, very hot. Okay? So, Chris, if you would just let me know when I ask where your skin falls on that scale, okay? This is going to help us determine whether or not we need to add subsequent layers or whether or not we need to go on to finish the procedure. It's important to saturate your gauze pad and to remember to return the lid. We don't want any evaporation of product. Using a Jesner peel, especially when you're trying to correct conditions such as textural lines, wrinkles, pores, so forth, you want to use a little bit more of a scrubbing action on the skin. So here we go. Just feather down lightly on the neck, moving across to the other side of the face. And again, feathering down on the neck. Okay, at this point, I like to apply the fan. And we'll have this product on the skin for approximately 5 to 6 minutes. It's always good to check with your client about their comfort level using that 1 to 10 scale. Always want to take the fan away to do that. So Chris, on a scale of 1 to 10, where would you say that your skin is?
Probably about a 6.
Okay. Does it feel like it's climbing or does it feel like it's kind of coming down now?
Oh, it's coming down now.
Okay. All right. So we still want to use the fan. We still need to cool that skin down just a little bit before we decide whether we're going to add subsequent layers or whether we're going to finish the treatment. So we're going to check the comfort level with Chris again, removing the fan and giving it just a second. Where would you say that you are now on that scale of 1 to 10?
Well, it seems to have cooled down a lot. I'd say a 2.
Okay. That's great. Well, then we can proceed. It's important to stay in contact with your client about their comfort level. Some clients, it can take maybe 5 to 10 minutes for their skin to go up and down that scale. So everybody's a little bit different. All right, this looks very good. So we're going to proceed with using the OPC serum, which has that comforting aloe base. We're going to evenly wipe that over the skin. Once that's been evenly distributed, we're going to add a little bit of the Peptide Repair Eye Cream around the eye area. Remember that she did mention the lines around her eyes. We're going to use a couple of the soft cotton pads for her eye area. We're going to saturate those with water. And then we're going to add just a drop of the OPC serum to add some hydration to the eye area. And now we're going to wrap the skin with a cool compress. We just retrieved this from the refrigerator, so it's a little cool, crisp. This will just calm that skin down further, take any redness out and any discomfort. We want to leave this on for about 5 minutes. It's very important to remember the benefits of OPC serum following any aesthetic treatment because OPC reparative serum contains a potent antioxidant, and this is very necessary to flood the skin with antioxidants following treatments like chemical peels or even your laser light-based therapies. That's because chemical peels are specifically stimulating cell metabolism. And with cell metabolism, we have cell respiration, which puts out free radicals. And antioxidants are there to neutralize those free radicals. So moving forward, we're going to use the Eternox Peptide Cream. The Eternox Peptide Cream is very soothing and hosts 3 peptides that can aid and accelerate the healing process. Remember that this formula is oil-free, so it's safe to use on any skin type. All right, once we have evenly distributed that over the face and neck, we want to use our Platinum Protection Facial Sunscreen. Once again, just apply this evenly over the skin. The zinc oxide in a 7.5% concentration not only protects the skin from the UVA and UVB sun rays, it's also an excellent anti-inflammatory effect on the skin. So it helps to soothe and take down any redness in the skin. To finish our treatment, I like to use the Anti-Aging Lip Complex. I like to apply this not only on the lips, but around the lips on the vermilion border. This also offers a soothing element to the lips and aids in hydration. Well, this concludes our Jesner's Chemical Peel treatment. Okay, Chris, so how does your skin feel?
Feels great.
Good. Okay, now you started with the Prepare Kit 10 days ago.
Yes.
Okay, so you're familiar with the products. I'm going to give you today the Prolong Kit for post-treatment. It's going to have all the same products, but it'll have one additional offering, and that's the New Peel Natural Enzyme Peel. Do you remember when I was preparing your skin and I put that on and it kind of balled up underneath my fingertips?
Yes.
Okay, that's the additional offering in the post-treatment kit, okay? And that's going to be good for removing that excess flakiness that you might start seeing in 2 to 3 days since your peel, okay? Now, this will last you about 10 days, and after that time frame, you'll have a follow-up appointment where you can come back into the office and we'll discuss your skin health maintenance treatment. This will be 4 products that you can continue to use to keep your skin in good shape. By providing your patients with the Prepare and the Prolong pre- and post-treatment kit, you maximize the results of your aesthetic treatment while minimizing any risks. This is also great to familiarize your patients with a treatment care program. This is 10 days of guided therapy in both the prepare and the prolonged treatment. Upon a follow-up visit, your patient easily transitions into a four-part skin renewal system to continue healthy skin.